everyone. In this video, we'll be talking about subacute sclerosing panencephalitis. Okay, subacute sclerosing panencephalitis. So, first thing is, this is an complication of measles. जो वायरल डिजीज होता है मिजल्स उसका ये कॉम्प्लिकेशन है. तो सपोज ए चाइल्ड सफर्ड फ्रॉम मिजल्स एट द ईयर ऑफ टू इयर्स ऑफ एज इज ही सफर्ड मिजल्स बट ही विल शो द सिम्टम्स ऑफ SSPE एट अराउंड 8 इयर्स. सो दिस डिजीज इज ऑफ डिलेड onset, okay, late manifestation, delayed onset, okay. So next thing, what are the symptoms we can see in this 8-year-old child? The clinical features will manifest in the 8-year-old child. So first is myoclonic jerks, okay. This measles occurs in the areas where the vaccination for measles are not available and the patient has been not given measles vaccination. These are the children who develop this SSPE, okay. So what are the first symptoms is myoclonic jerks. Number two, neurodegenerative features. What does neurodegenerative features means? Like you can see the child is 8 years now. So before he was good in his studies and suddenly you can see that his grades have come down. He is not studying well as he used to do before. So this is neurodegenerative features manifesting in the child. Okay. Then the third thing is the development of apathy. Like he does not relate with his family members or anyone. Like he becomes aloof from them. Like maybe he was before the youngest child in his family and he was loved by his parents so much and he also had affection for them, but now he develops apathy towards them, okay. Then number four is urinary incontinence. Matlab kya hota hai, he starts passing urine and stool in the bed only, okay. Fine. So these are the symptoms of clinical features of SSPE. Now how we will diagnose this SSPE? So first is through the clinical feature, okay. So first we will see the clinical features and through that we will diagnose. Then number two is through EEG. Okay, so what we will see in EEG? Periodic stereotype high voltage discharge. Periodic stereotyped high voltage discharge. Okay, then number three, this is very important, is cerebrospinal fluid study. Okay, here we will see raised immunoglobulin or oligoclonal pattern. Okay, so this is important. What we will see in CSF? Raised immunoglobulin. This is, you have to remember, raised immunoglobulin. And then we also will see measles antibodies. This also we study. Raised titer of measles antibody, raised titer in serum and also in cerebrospinal fluid. Number five is brain biopsy. Okay, so this was all about SSPE. Let's revise once. So subacute sclerosing panencephalitis, it is a complication of measles. It comes as a question in microbiology that SSPE is the complication of which viral disease? That is measles. Okay. Then child suffered from measles at 2 years of age, and SSP develops at around 8 years. Means it has delayed onset. It takes time to develop. Okay. Now, what are the clinical features? We see myoclonic jerks in the patient, neurodegenerative disorders, features, apathy, and urinary incontinence. Okay. Then how we will diagnose? We will diagnose through clinical features, through EEG, through cerebrospinal fluid, through measles antibodies, and through brain biopsy. So this was all about SSPE.